da mulher por he put a condition that if I will try to destroy or demolish a building, you will not stop me, otherwise I'm not going to plan. So he just board planning he did. And this, many buildings were demolished. And then it was successful, otherwise it would have not succeeded. That is one experiment. The other experiment is routine study. Delhi, Nayi Delhi is called Delhi. This Nayi Delhi plan is नई दिल्ली आप समझते हैं कि यहाँ कुछ था नहीं क्या जो सीधी सीधी सड़कें बन गई या मकान बन गए और यहाँ पे बड़ा बड़ा गांव था रायसीना हिल के नीचे जो राष्ट्रपति भवन है उसके नीचे एक गांव था जिसका नाम भी रायसीना था तो लुटियन साहब ने कहा कि ये गांव तो हटेगा अब हमारी प्लानिंग क्या है द विलेजेस आर इंक्लूडेड इन द प्लान सिचुएशन सो वी हैव अर्बन कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ अर्बन तो मुनीर का बिल्कुल जेएनयू से सटा हुआ एक अर्बन विलेज है तो जिया सराय कटवारिया सराय लाडू सराय आल दी सरायदार आपको अर्बन विलेज है तो दे हैव नॉट बीन डिमोलिश्ड एंड रिमूव्ड दे हैव बीन केप्ट देयर इंटैक्ट बट सर्टेन अमाउंट ऑफ प्लानिंग हैज बीन डन सम फैसिलिटीज हैव बीन क्रिएटेड सो व्हाट हैपेंड टू रायसीना रायसीना का नाम सुना आपको रायसीना रोड है कभी किसी ने सुना है दिल्ली रायसीना गया कहाँ रायसीना को ये शर्त लगा दी कि जो रीच है इसके पीछे जाएगा ताकि अंग्रेज बहादुर के सामने ये इस तरह का सेटलमेंट ना दिखाई पड़े तो वो गांव उजाड़ के करोलबाग से और पीछे जो आज का बेगरपुरा है वहां पर सेटल कर दिया गया अब वो भी शहर बन गया तो पता नहीं रायसीना कोई वहां भी जानता है कि नहीं Then this whole area was planned on the paper, which was green area. So Lutyens was able to create new day. The same happened in Chandigarh by Lakar Gujiye. पता नहीं लाकार गुजिये का मतलब कोई जानते हैं क्या प्रॉब्लम कोई student teacher नहीं तुम तो बता दो लाकार गुजिये जो उसका planner था उसका क्या नाम नहीं था उसका ये French architect था Any idea? Any guess? लगातार मुझे कौवे को कहते हैं।
He is the good father of the Chandigarh city. हाँ। He is the good father of the Chandigarh city because he developed the city in a very like linear and the linear pattern in the grid pattern right. to make the city very fluent way.
Right.
So it's a very big master sir. We get to learn from them in the many many manners way.
लेकिन उसने भी अजीब planning की है. North की तरफ sir, High Court और Secretariat. अब यहाँ पर sir ही होता है, नहीं दिमाग वहाँ होता है, नहीं समझ नहीं है. और फिर sector 17 जो है वो पेट business और जो civil disposal है वो पैर की तरफ. क्या मतलब है इसका? किस तरह की planning है? जिसमें आपने human body को ही औंधा सीधा कर दिया और आपने सर वहां बनाया जहां वो काफी हेडसेट हो गए थे सब पास सब दिमाग खा रहे हैं लेकिन ठीक है उसकी अपनी प्लानिंग की थी तो स्मार्ट सिटी कहीं अलग से नहीं बन रहे हैं जो 100 सिटी हमारे सरकार ने अनाउंस किया है तो हम स्मार्ट बनाए उसका हमें समझना चाहिए कि इसकी बेसिक फिलॉसफी आज के शहर की गवर्नेंस कौन कर रहा है आज के शहरों की गवर्नेंस म्युनिसिपल कॉर्पोरेशन कर रहा है म्युनिसिपैलिटी करती है और उनका क्या काम है वो अपने फाइनेंसेस बढ़ाते हैं दे हैव देयर फाइनेंसेस और फिर उसके बाद चाहे वो प्रॉपर्टी टैक्स से हो चाहे और तरह तरह के टैक्सेस हैं एक्साइज ड्यूटी वगैरह भी स्टेट को मिलती है अब जीएसटी मिल रहा है जो जीएसटी में सीएसटी है वो स्टेट का ही तो इससे पैसा उनको मिलता है सिटी को भी और उसको वो खर्च करते हैं आपके ट्रांसपोर्ट पे आपके मूवमेंट पर आपके हेल्थ पे आपके एजुकेशन पे तो आप जो है टैक्स दे रहे हैं और जो अस्पताल जाते हैं वहाँ फीस दे रहे हैं और जब जून में जाते हैं तो वहां भी, लेकिन जब आप स्मार्ट हो जाएंगे तो ध्यान रखिएगा क्या होगा। स्मार्ट सिटी मींस दैट इट ऑल इज गोइंग टू बी प्राइवेटाइज्ड एंड एवरी सिटीजन विल हैव टू पे फॉर यूजर चार्जेस। आपको हर तरह के चार्ज देना पड़ेगा क्योंकि वो प्राइवेट मैनेजमेंट है, वो म्युनिसिपैलिटी नहीं, वो सरकार वहां से हाथ खींच रही है। वो क्या रहा है कि इन द होल सिचुएशन हमारा जो समाज है वो एक तिपाही पे है। तिपाही में एक तरफ तो सरकार है, स्टेट है, दूसरी तरफ सिविल सोसाइटी है और तीसरी तरफ मार्केट है। हमारा समाज इस वक्त जो है इस पर टिका हुआ है, स्टेट, मार्केट एंड सिविल सोसाइटी। व्हाट इज हैपनिंग, स्टेट इज विथड्रॉइंग। पहले सारे अस्पताल स्टेट चलाती थी, अब प्राइवेट चलाते हैं। और अगर भगवान ना करे आप वहां पहुंच गए तो बस के आ जाइए, तो बहुत बड़ी बात है। क्योंकि वो कहा है ना हमारे यहाँ कि वैद्यराज नमस्तुभ्यं यमराज सहोदरा, हे वैद्यराज मैं आपको नमस्कार करता हूँ क्योंकि आप यमराज के बड़े भाई। यमस्तु हरति प्राणानि, यमस्तु हरति प्राणानि वैद्यतु धनं च। वैद्य जो यम जो है वो तो सिर्फ प्राण देता है और वैद्य जी जो है वो धन और प्राण दोनों ले लेते हैं। ये धन जो आज के दिन आपका जो जाता है वो प्राइवेट की वजह से बोला है, कोई उसमें लगाम नहीं है। कितना लेंगे, कितनी चीज का, एक सिरिंज का 50 रुपए लेंगे, 5 रुपए की, कितना वो चार्ज करते हैं। सो इट इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट व्हेन दी प्राइवेट मार्केट फोर्सेस का मार्केट इज वेरी यूजलेस। स्टेट विड्रॉ करेगी तो मार्केट आ गया है। और इफ द सिविल सोसाइटी इज वीक, आप ज्यादा शोर और नहीं मचा पाएंगे तो फिर यू आर डूम। फिर तो मार्केट ही मार्केट है, मार्केट हर चीज को अपने नजरिए से।
नेक्स्ट वी हैव पीस पोलावाले, आई रिक्वेस्ट आयुष मैम टू वेलकम पीस पोलावाले। Next special guest, Osman Jolo. I request Dr. Phool Kumar to welcome him to booking. Next we have Ojong Emmanuel Ogar. I'll request Ashwini to welcome him with bouquet. Next we have E. Polardi. I'll request Manisha Lal ma'am to welcome him with bouquet. We are really inviting to resource person Dr. Kalu Malik, Associate Professor, NCR, New Delhi. And I'll request...
Professor Qureshi has already introduced something about smart city. I'm not going to that aspect, but maybe make some reference. मैं ये कहना चाहता हूँ कि हम लोग कुछ चीज को कंफ्यूज करते हैं। एक शब्द होता अर्बन और एक होता सिटी। हम समझते हैं कि जो सिटी अर्बन बड़ा होकर सिटी बन जाता है, जैसे प्रोफेसर प्रेसी ने कहा कि ए ग्रोन विलेज बिकम्स अर्बन। ये एक धारणा है जो सही नहीं। सिमिलरली ए वेल डेवलप्ड अर्बन सेंटर इज नॉट ए सिटी। In fact, city and urban are two diametrically opposite things. City में बिना citizen के city नहीं हो सकती। आज बहुत सारे को city कहा जाता है, माइनस द सिटी असृजन से जी। इसलिए एक हिंदी के गायक हैं, उन्होंने कहा है व्यक्ति यदि व्यक्तित्व रहित और व्यक्तिहीन समाज, दिस इज अर्बन। जहां व्यक्ति का व्यक्तित्व नहीं है और ऐसे व्यक्तियों के समूह को अर्बन कहते हैं। अर्बन इज बेसिकली यू कैन नॉट बी अर्बनाइज्ड अनलेस यू आर एलिनेटेड। अर्बन यूरोप में जो अर्बनाइजेशन आज हम समझते हैं, ग्रीक सिटीज में सिटी में सिटीजन होती थी। उसकी अलग बात है कि सिटीजनशिप का क्राइटेरिया बहुत गलत था, वहां केवल संभ्रांत और समृद्ध व्यक्तियों को सिटीजनशिप माना था। स्लेव्स यू आर नॉट पार्ट ऑफ सिटीजनशिप, बट नॉनetheless दोज वर सिटीज, दे वर सिटीजंस, दे हैड राइट टू द सेल्फ। मैं कौन हूं ये चीज आप लोग आज महसूस करते होंगे, ये फ्री गिफ्ट नहीं आई है। आपका ये कहना कि मैं कौन हूं, मेरा एक अस्तित्व है, ये इतिहास की एक बहुत बड़ी लड़ाई है और ये लड़ाई सिटी में पहले लड़ी गई, अर्बन में ये नहीं है। खैर अहमद खैर कहते हैं इन दमक के शहरों के फरावा मखलूक की उम्मत में हसरत में किया करती है, ये हंसी खेल फटा पड़ता है जो जिसका किसलिए फकत किस्म भूख उगा करती है। आज आप लोग दौड़ रहे हैं किसके लिए, जो ढूंढ रहे वो नहीं मिलता, मौत जरूर मिल जाती है। बैंगलोर द हैपनिंग सिटी ऑफ इंडिया 2011 का डेटा मैं आपको बताता हूँ।
रोला सर, बाय पेंटिंग दिस पर पिक्चर ऑफ अर्बन इंडिया, आई थिंक अर्बन एरिया से हम एक्चुअली sustain the growth of our nation. They have all the immigrants from the rural areas got employment in urban areas, and the urban areas of our country have proved the role model for the world. And our last 2 decades of IT revolution has really got roots just because our urban areas would sustain good workplaces for them. Our very swanky neighborhoods, the workplaces which came up with the participation of private developers have really matched the global workplaces. And why the smart city idea came? Because these islands of swanky buildings could not be supported infrastructurally by the rest of the town. The people were unable to utilize their energies into positive and the wastage of time and efficiency was there in the route. So while on the one side we were able to reach the maximum in the communication technologies, we were like 2G, 3G, 4G, and we were teaching the world in the communication sector, while our mobility sector was far behind. And our IT sector, which is like engine of growth for the urbanization of the country, was suffering a little bit just because of this. Our IT
city planning and management, we want it to be sustainable. But my question is, which I want to put to us, if you look at the rural areas and the cities, where do we have more crime happening? Where do we have more suicide cases happening? Is it in the cities or in the villages? I'm asking. Recently, we are told that for every 24 hours, about 20 students commit suicide in India, in the cities. So, I'm not against smart city, but I also want to just suggest maybe we can also think of how to make our villages to be smart. We can look at smart villages. bring development to the village where the people are, and that will reduce the rural urban migration. The rural urban migration has been there for many years, and it brings a lot of pressure, a lot of pressure. Why can't we bring development to the place where the people are within the context of their living? That is one suggestion. I know the developers will always think of the cities because they make money from there and all of that. But the other aspect is the psychological dimension, the mental pressure that comes with working in cities. As we develop smart cities, let there be conscious efforts to develop psychological centers that can take care of the mental pressures that comes with working in cities. I think a professor mentioned it, if I got him well, because there was a bit of Hindi. There was a lady working and he had two husbands or something like that, working night and that's one of the challenges of working in the city. That is against family values. And most institutions do not have psychological, you know, aspects, you know, to their work. Even in the universities, we teach psychology as a course, but many students do not, you know, receive the real, you know, learning and teachings of what psychology is. There's no application. Every institution is encouraged to have, you know, an arm where the staff of those organizations are able to access psychotherapy, help when needed. Talking about Gurgaon, I live in Gurgaon, like our last speaker, you know, did. Almost on a monthly basis, there is a crisis at the Karate Daulat toll gate. Because the village has come, they want to pass away free without paying. As we talk about smart city, we need to think about the conflict that comes because of acquisition of land. These are some of the mental health issues that affect people living in cities. The other day I was reading in the newspaper how a leopard killed two young people in India here. I was so traumatized. So we need to look at the trauma, you know, the mental trauma that comes with urbanization. And the only way we can do that is not just by criticizing that we shouldn't have smart cities, but we should do something about it, which is we need to embrace, you know, psychotherapy input in every aspect of governance. I know it is something that sometimes conflicts with our culture, because like Indians and Africans, we have what we call the shame culture. When we talk about mental health, the first thing that comes to people's mind is that somebody is mad. But when somebody is under serious stress and is not dealt with, begins to be obese. So problem of obesity is there in the cities, many of the Western countries, and all around the world. All because as we develop cities, there is always the thinking that the beauty of a city, the smoothness of the road, the constant electricity supply, all these are the things that bring happiness. But it is not always the case. So there is a need, in summary, to invest in human development. That is the main point I want to pass across. We need to invest in human development. If we invest in people through appropriate psychological education, psycho-education, even before we start all the smart city projects and all of that, we need to psycho-educate the people so that people will be able to understand what we intend to do. And it's not going to be that it's one side that's going to benefit. If you psycho-educate people from childhood right to teenage level to adolescence, it will help reduce a lot of crises that we face today in our world, which include rape, drug cases, all kinds of evil effects of the movies, even that people watch. So this is my take in this aspect, human development, so that because the smart city is not being developed for angels, it's being developed for human beings to live in. So if the people that we intend to build a city for are not smart mentally. Because we talk of smart city, we need to talk of smart people. But when we talk of smart people, I don't mean somebody dressed in suits and tie. I'm talking about somebody who is smart in the brain, who is able to reason appropriately, who knows that it is not right to rape a woman, who knows that it is not right to bully somebody, who knows that it is not right to oppress anybody. And that can only happen when we give psychological intervention the right place in the society. Thank you very much.
Deals with school education. And I always, like wherever I go, I always end up correlating the topic with what all we are teaching in the schools. And I always find that whichever is happening at a larger platform, about that, what we are teaching at the school level, what all we have given in the textbook. But again, since it's a new concept and I was thinking about it, yet it hasn't appeared in our textbooks. But I kept on pondering over it, I kept on thinking about it, that what I should speak about the smart cities. Then finally, I got stuck with the idea of issues and challenges. As the speaker spoke right now, same thing, means I think on the same lines. I shifted to Delhi in 2004. And even at that time, the same lines came in my mind which Professor Qureshi spoke just now. Akhil ji ki kavita se, ki sar, tum sabhe to huye nahi, dasna bhi tumhe nahi aaya, phir kahan se sikha tumne ye sab, itna wish kahan paaya. This is what is reflected in the people of Delhi, like the way they behave on the road and in the city. See, most of the cities, they are planned. They are planned by somebody. The houses, they are also approved. They are also planned in some manner. But again, think about walking on the road of a Delhi. You cannot, because there is so much of traffic. People, they do not follow the rules. Even on the zebra crossing, hardly many cars stop. So where are the values, where all these things have gone among the people? If somebody meets with an accident, half of the people are just mute spectators. Where they are inside the human bodies, which does not allow them to help others. So what we'll do with the smart cities, what we'll do with the infrastructure, if there are no human values inside us. Then, instead of the road, if you start walking on the footpath, again, believe me, in Delhi, I could not walk on a footpath even for half a kilometer. Because even the footpaths, they are encroached by various people. Then where, as a pedestrian, I'm supposed to walk? Somebody said, go to Lutyens Delhi. That is so beautiful and so nice. I agree, that is very beautiful because that's posh area and okay, it's like a challenge. They have occupied their bungalows over there. Again, I started walking on a footpath. Believe me, even in that Lutyens Delhi, I could not walk half a kilometer on a footpath. Again, those rich, they have encroached those footpaths for their security guards. Is it the right value? Is it the right thing they are doing? We are supposed to ask each other that in these smart cities, forget about the Delhi, even the Delhi Minister. Sure, most of you must be getting a phone call from somebody. You take loan just once and all life long you are harassed by the same company again and again. Now take loan for something else. Now another thing, like initially we took a loan for our car, till late we are receiving the phone call. Then take loan for a house, take loan for another car. Means every day we are refusing this kind of thing. And not only that, means get your refrigerator repaired, get your RO services done, get your car service done. Since the phone calls are endless, I shared my data only at one place. But again, why others are misusing it? This is not the idea of the smart city I want. I basically want smart people. Smart people, again, as he said, not in the dress sense, in their mentality, where they learn to help each other. Because I want, as Satyapriya has said, that the concept is well-timed for the smart cities because it has been given now. But again, just ponder over it. Are we ready? Government is ready with the idea. They are ready to give us the infrastructure. They are ready to give us the facilities. But are we there to help other fellow human beings If somebody is in a need, if somebody is suffering, are we there to volunteer, to give our helping hand, to help them? Just think about these things, because these are needed more. In our textbook, we teach all these things. But unfortunately, in today's time, what is happening? That whatever the values we are giving in the textbook, whether they are related to the environment, or whether they are related to sensitivity toward fellow human beings. But again, we just learn them to pass from one class to another class. We never ever invite them in our lives. We all know we are supposed to protect the environment, but how many of us are actually doing it? How many of us are actually helping the others? Just ponder over it. Because I want that these smart cities, they should be a good living place for you, for me, and the entire human race. Thank you very much.
But all these speakers highlighted the things, think that smartness is something different, and the real issue should be the smart human being. And we should respect, we should ponder each other's needs and all those things. And thank you once more. Project International Seminar Seeds was thrown 1 year back.
Those persons are very
fruitful
to the participants as well. Thank you.
सभी आदरणीय विराजमान हैं, छात्राएं और छात्र विराजमान हैं। स्मार्ट सिटी के इस विषय पर आपने विस्तार से सुना। मैं हिंदी का विद्यार्थी हूं, मैं क्या समझता हूं कि शायर की चार पंक्तियां सुनाता हूं आप लोगों को। ये शहर के पास जो हम अपने गांव बेचते हैं, ये शहर के पार जो हम अपने गांव बेचते हैं, सच मानिए अपने हाथ पांव बेचते हैं। तुम पूछते हो मोल मेरी मोहब्बत का, तुम्हें किसने कहा पेड़ अपनी छांव बेचते हैं। था आपके मन को हल्का करने के लिए आपको एक स्मार्ट सिटी का जो कंसेप्ट है मेरी मुक्तक में दिखाई देगा कि बेमतलब मेरे ख्वाबों को खुदकुशी करनी पड़ी, बेमतलब मेरे ख्वाबों को खुदकुशी करनी पड़ी, परिंदों को अपने पर जला के रोशनी करनी पड़ी, एक अपने के प्यार को भुलाने के लिए जाने कितने बेगानों से दोस्ती करनी पड़ी।
speech was amazing.
You want to go outside?